Brock Purdy, Trey Lance. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a battle over there. It is a, you know, it's a battle in the trenches over there. Talk to me about in the padded practices, because we gave everybody kind of our, you know, we want rundown in the reels on YouTube. Talk to me about how you've been feeling about the team so far in pads, man. You know what I mean? Trey Lance, Brock Purdy, your defense. What is it looking like?
In the pads, Trey Lance has been great the last 2 days in pads, but you know, the media don't talk about it. The media always talk about what he does negatively, but he's been great in the pads, and he's been doing what he had to do with every situation he's been in. This is the first day he actually got to throw passes to Christian McCaffrey. Before then, Christian McCaffrey was only rocking with Brock Purdy. This is, I think yesterday was the day that he finally threw a pass to Brandon Ayuk. Before that, Brandon Ayuk was only rocking with Brock Purdy. So I feel like just Trey Lance in this situation, that he's been doing what he can with what he's been given. Brock Purdy, he had a bad day yesterday, but he came back stronger today. It's definitely like up and down. It's definitely a quarterback competition going on. I just feel like between the quarterback competition, they're going with Brock Purdy. It's given to me that Brock Purdy is our starter. He's going to be quarterback one going into week one. And I get it. We going off what you did for me lately. What you did for me lately, Brock Purdy won. He went on a winning streak, won 2 playoff games. So that's why they're going to go with Brock Purdy. Trey Lance, he's still an unknown. He got hurt early. You know what I mean? So they're still trying to go off of that. And I feel like the competition with Trey Lance and Sam Darnold is for quarterback two. I expect Trey Lance to win quarterback two. And then we'll go from there. The defense has been stellar. You know what I mean? Brock Purdy threw a few interceptions. Sam Darnold threw a few interceptions. You know what I mean? And I expect that. You know what I mean? It was a few sacks going on. Drake Jackson. I'm going to tell y'all about Drake Jackson right now. I told people last year, Taylor Noah Hufanga was going to make a leap year two, and he made all pro. Drake Jackson is another name y'all need to look out for. I'm not saying Drake Jackson is going to make all pro another none of that, but he's going to make a leap where – the NFL is going to be on notice about Drake Jackson. So make sure y'all look out for that name. Jake Moody, he was a kicker. I was upset when we drafted Jake Moody because I'm like, why would you take a kicker in the third round? But the kid been proving me wrong. Made a 60-yard field goal, 58, 33, 48. I'm like, okay, this kid making me a believer. So it's a lot going on. Great in a 49ers camp. And we haven't paid Nick Bosa yet, but don't trip. That check coming. We ain't tripping.
Maybe it's coming. Y'all gonna cut the check. Let me ask you a question here. What is the possibility of, because I mean, y'all head coach said it, not us, but we know that he compares Sam Darnold to
Steve Young.
Y'all really gotta be in our group chats, bro. You know, he compared him to Steve Young in the sense of he could turn his career around at some point. You know, if Steve Young did it, why not Sam, Big Sam Darnold? How do you feel about your head coach and those comments, Hev? Lou, matter of fact, both of y'all can kind of chime in on this because, you know, y'all felt like that Kyle was trolling, and you know, Mark and I was like, you know, nah, he.
Yeah, I felt like he was full of shit.
He meant what he said. I had people text me on
the side like, why is Kyle playing mind games and he trolling right now?
He likes. What's his name? What's his name again?
Sam Darnold.
He likes Sam Darnold.
No, like one thing about Kyle.
Kyle is full of.
Oh God, go ahead, Lou. I'll let my man Lou go, and then I'll finish it off.
Kyle is full of shit. Like, ain't no way in hell he really thinks Sam Darnold can turn his career around. This man been in the league, what, 5 years? Is it 5 years now, something like that? Six?
It's been like five.
It's something like that.
At the minimum, five.
He ain't turning nothing around. This man is a glorified backup at this point.
Saw Geno Smith turn his career
around. That's what I was about to say. He only in year five, and y'all dogging him like this, like he can't. We saw Baker Mayfield take the Browns.
Okay, hold on. Geno went back and said,
what did Baker Mayfield look like after he left the Browns?
Yeah. And Geno went and sat behind a veteran quarterback, and they put him within that system that he was that veteran quarterback just left. And they put him in that system, and it works. and he works within that system. So therefore, he has been successful. Taking no credit away from Geno, but he's been placed in a system that helps him be successful. He's working within that system. Sam Darnold is not going to be he's not a good quarterback. He wasn't a good quarterback coming out of USC. And matter of fact, he got recruited to USC as a linebacker and ended up switching to a quarterback. The man.
Yeah, what happened, Heavy? I thought it was fight on, bro.
Listen, Mark.
He really is supposed to be rolling for Sam Darnold for real.
First and foremost, when Sam Darnold was at USC, I knew what I was getting. I knew that. And so I'm not surprised at what I see in the NFL. I'm not surprised at all.
Why was Sam Darnold such a hype? Because he was a hype guy. Like, he was a hyped up guy. Because
it's USC.
Because it was USC.
Every quarterback that comes out of USC.
The same way Mark Sanchez was a hype. And we saw what Mark Sanchez was when he got in the NFL.
And what's his name? John David Booty. They hyped him up too.
Let me tell you something. The only quarterback they can't. Bro, we had one quarterback. We got two quarterbacks I could say that's going to come out and be successful. One was Carson Palmer. He had a solid career. And Caleb Williams. Everybody else, y'all saw Matt Leinart. He won a Heisman. And when he came in the league, he was
They hyped him up.
And they hyped Matt Leinart up. But I knew when Matt Leinart got in the league, he wasn't going to be that. I knew that. Like, y'all don't understand. Us USC fans, we be knowing.
Mark, I feel you, Mark. That's crazy.
Kyle Shanahan, that's crazy. Kyle Shanahan
Hollywood
understands
said the fight
that
is all for real. That's crazy.
Yeah, hey, listen, Hollywood.
It's insane when Kyle, it comes to Sam Darnold. Wow.
Kyle Shanahan understands that the media is paying attention to our quarterback controversy. So yeah. Kyle's going to give y'all what y'all want because y'all got to make stories. They got to make headlines. So Kyle's going to get what they want. Steve Young, come on, dog. Like, you, come on. But I get the point where he's trying to make this saying that, you know what I mean, you could start off bad and end up good somewhere else. Like Mark said, Geno Smith.
He's going to end up being a great comparison for y'all at some point this season.
He's definitely not going to be our starting quarterback.
To be fair, your quarterbacks get hurt a lot.
They always get hurt, though.
We do. So this is why Kyle Shanahan said we can roll with three quarterbacks. And I'm like, Kyle, I'm not mad at you at that because we saw what happened in the NFC Championship. So I'm cool with you rolling with three quarterbacks. Listen, I don't give a damn. If we put Shooter, Mark, or Lou at quarterback, long as we get that sixth trophy, I don't give a damn. I don't care who's at quarterback at the end of the day. You know what I'm saying?
Hollywood had a question before.
I mean, she a hater. She a hater.
We are going to talk Colts real quick to a small capacity because most of that stuff, we only talk Jonathan Taylor, so I do want to talk Colts a little bit about the other stuff that's going on, Lou. But Hollywood said, do you think y'all try to trade off Trey, try to get some draft capital back if he's not QB1? I think you kind of answered it a little bit as far as like Shanahan saying that y'all gonna roll with the three quarterbacks.
It won't be this year because honestly, what you gonna get for Trey? A lot of other teams don't know nothing about him. He been hurt. What can you trade for? He's an unknown. You can't trade for a quarterback that you really don't know about. So they're not gonna give up draft capital for a player they really can't give a really ain't got no tape on. So I feel like for this year, Trey will still be there. I can't tell you about next year, but you know, I'm still rooting for Trey because like everything is against him, and I'm going to always root for the underdog. So I don't, it won't be this year, Hollywood, that they trade.
And there's no point in trading them now, considering all the injuries you guys have had at quarterback in the past. And the draft is already over, so you're not going to be able to get nothing for it this year. So it makes no sense.
I agree with you, bro. 1,000%. It makes no sense.
Yeah, somebody said, is this Bray? Bray? Bray said the best thing Sam could be is Ryan Fitzpatrick.
How many playoff games did Ryan Fitzpatrick play in?
Crazy though. Hold up.
How many playoff games did Ryan Fitzpatrick play in?
Insane though. Like, there's a couple of times we saw Fitzmagic was crazy.
Yeah, there's a couple of times we've seen Sam Darnold play good, and he's still ass. So what?
Fitzmagic only been Fitzmagic for like three games. And then after that, he back to Fitzpatrick.
Yeah. Shout out to the Commanders for making him a starting quarterback at one point.